Yo, what is going on, guys? My name is Yankee, and welcome back to a brand new video. So earlier this week, Treyarch added in a brand new feature into Black Ops 4 called the Black Market. This is your tier system where you're gonna level it up to unlock brand new cosmetics such as emotes, specialist skins, blackout characters, signature weapons, and much, much more. Recently, I've seen a bunch of comments asking me exactly how do you guys think that we can level these things up a lot faster so you guys can go ahead and get to your tier 200 as fast as possible, because a lot of people have been saying it takes quite some time to actually rank some of these things up. So in today's video, we're gonna go ahead and give you guys some of the best tips that I have for you guys to go ahead and level up these tiers as fast as possible and unlock this brand new signature weapon, blackout characters, and all the other stuff that's in the item shop. But before we get into this, I do want to go ahead and ask each and every single one of you guys to smack an early like on the video. If we can get up to 100 likes today, it'd be really greatly appreciated. It helps the channel out a ton. Also, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. We are on that road to 17,000 subscribers. Hopefully we can hit that fairly soon. Now, without further ado, let's get into the video. We're gonna start off here talking to you guys about how long you actually have to unlock all of these tiers. So we have two events going on in the black market right now, called the Operation First Strike, and we also have the Halloween event. So in the Halloween event, we only have 20 tiers that you have to go through. You also have 12 days to do this, so you have not too much time to actually unlock this stuff. But as if you play a lot of the game, you're going to be able to unlock that pretty quickly. But if we move over to the other event, where we have 50 days left to get to 200 tiers, this one's going to be a little more challenging for you, which is something that I want to go ahead and just kind of explain how we can rank this up as fast as possible. So you guys do the math, we have about 50 days remaining to go through 200 tiers. So this basically means that if you want to get to tier 200, you need to go through at least 4 tiers every single day from now until the end of this event to actually get to tier 200. It sounds like it's going to be difficult, but it's not as difficult if you actually play the right game modes, you actually play the right games, and if you just are somebody that's gonna sit around and play for a decent amount of time every single day. So starting off here, we're gonna talk, the first tip I can give you guys, literally just play the damn game. There's really nothing else to it besides playing the damn game. That's something that sounds pretty obvious, but you really, the more you play this game, the more you're gonna rank up your tiers. Basically, it doesn't necessarily matter how much XP you're gonna get into the games, it doesn't really matter how many kills you're gonna get into a game either. All that stuff you can throw out the window. Obviously, it's gonna be cool to get a lot of kills in a game, but that really is not the nitty gritty exactly how you're gonna wanna rank up these tiers. Literally, it's just to play the game. If you're struggling a little bit and you're not playing the game too well, don't take it out on it, and you're not gonna have too much stress on it either. You're literally, it's not really gonna focus too much on how much XP you're getting or how many kills you're getting. It literally is just straight up how much game time you're actually playing. So the more times you're playing this game, you're gonna actually level your tiers up that much faster at the same time. But there are a few game modes that I personally found that are a lot easier and a lot faster ways to actually rank up your level. So the number one game mode that I can actually give you guys right now, I mean, I don't know how many of you guys actually have enjoyed this so far, but Blackout is by far the absolute best way that you guys can go ahead and level these tiers up super quickly. So in about 2 to 3 games of me playing Blackout, which sometimes the games can last for about 20 to 30 minutes, about 2 to 3 games I've been leveling up my tiers super quickly, compared to if I'm just playing like a hard point with some friends. That usually took me about like almost an hour just to get through one tier, which really is a little frustrating. So if you're actually playing fast in Blackout, say you drop like 6 kills real quick and then you die maybe like in your top 15 and you only played for about 10 to 15 minutes, you might even go through like either a half or a full tier just from that one game alone, as long as you're playing pretty well, as long as you're staying alive and you're actually gonna make it to the end of the game. Because that's the one thing I need to stress, because if you're gonna die right away in Blackout, there's probably no point of you to play that, because you're not gonna get many tiers unlocked at all through that. So definitely, if you're playing Blackout, make sure you're at least playing well so you can extend that game, try to at least get to top 15, and then you can just, if you die, it doesn't really matter at that point. You should be able to at least get through it by minimum at least a half a tier every single time. That's definitely gonna help you out a ton. But if you really don't want to play Blackout though, a couple of other game modes that I personally have found to really help me are TDM, Free For All, and also Kill Confirmed. The reason why I want to play these game modes, you can kind of get through them pretty quickly, and also matters on how many games you're playing at the same time. So if you're gonna go ahead, you're playing TDM, you're getting through these games super quickly, say you're playing like a 30-minute span, you get like 4 to 5 games in just because you're playing really fast, you might go through a tier and a half at that point, which is going to help you tons to level up these tiers. Again, like I said, it's all playtime, how many games you are playing, how much time you actually have put into the game to be able to go ahead and unlock all these tiers. One thing that I personally found to actually not be beneficial to me, and I don't know if this is just like a coincidence or maybe you guys have been finding the same issue as well. Last night I was playing in a full party, we were playing my domination and hardpoint, like a lot of objective based game modes. I honestly wasn't ranking up as fast as I thought I should have been. I don't know if this is just something that, like, if you're in a full party. It's maybe not going to give you as much XP, and it maybe benefits more people that are playing solo at that point. I really highly don't think this is true, but it was kind of weird to me that when I played Domination at Hardpoint yesterday, it took me almost like an hour and a half just to get through like a half of a level in my tier. So that was kind of weird. I don't know if you guys have been having the same issue or not. Definitely let me know about that, but that's just something I kind of wanted to throw in there to possibly take it, keep your eye open for as well. But moving on though, I do want to say that eventually it does seem like they're going to go ahead and throw COD points into this game. I would assume it's still probably a few weeks away until we actually officially do see COD points, but when they do add COD points, definitely keep an eye out. If you guys aren't getting through your levels as fast as you want, you should be able to actually purchase your tiers, whether you're going to be able at a time purchase 10 or 20 tiers at a time to get up a little higher, give you a little more of an advantage, because that's something I personally might even be doing too, because 4 tiers a day, it sounds a little crazy to be completely honest. It almost seems like you have to play like 4 hours a day just to make sure you're gonna get to tier 200 by the time that this event actually is over. So maybe just give you a little bit of an edge so you don't have to have a lot of stress of making sure if you miss a day, you have to get through 8 tiers a day. Maybe just going ahead and like buying like 10 to 20 tiers could just give you a little bit of a benefit to give you some leeway. But this is also something that's not really recommended if you don't play too much of the game, because like if you're not really playing too much of this game, you might really not want to buy too many tiers, because maybe it doesn't matter benefit to you going to buy these tiers at the same time, because maybe you don't really care about going for this like blackout skin or whatever. Unless you really want these skins and you really need to go ahead and spend some COD points, that's probably the only other option that I can give you. But the last tip that I can give you guys, I can almost guarantee you 100% there is going to be some kind of a weekend to have you to give you double XP or maybe even some quad XP to leveling these tiers up faster. Make sure you keep an eye out for those, because that is going to be the absolute best way that you can go ahead and rank these tiers up as fast as possible when there are those double XP weekends. The weekend we're currently in right now, there's double XP in the game, so you're leveling up your prestiges faster. I can almost guarantee the next weekend or the weekend after that, there's going to be double XP for your tiers to level those things up even faster than that. But anyway, those are the tips that I have for you guys. Make sure you're playing this game as much as possible. That is the absolute best way that you guys can rank up your tiers. Blackout, in my opinion, is the best option. If you can't do Blackout, definitely play like TDM, Kill Confirmed, or Free For All. Those will help you out a ton as well. But anyway, that's going to do it here for today's video. Hopefully this did help you guys out. If it did, make sure you guys smack that like button and subscribe to the channel if you are new. I'll catch you all in the next video. Thank you all so much for watching. Have a great rest of your day, and peace out.
Got an assist.
Give me my heals. Give me my heals.
Enemies are contesting zone B.
Oh shoot!
That's probably one of my worst games.
Enemies contesting Alpha.
There's another one over here somewhere. Reload. Oh my god! Level 3. Oh, look at this vision pulse. This guy just turned on me.
Enemies contesting Bravo.
Oh my god! 3-piece! Oh, there's a dog! Dang it, man! Oh no. Richard C, thank you so much for the sub. Look at that, dude! Look at the kills that we were getting there. Dang, man. Oh, we got a helicopter. Let's get it. Crash requesting attack. We got all streaks. Where are we going? Boom. Double kill, baby. Oh, shoot. Where's the last one? Oh, my God. Look at me, dude. 39-9, bro. Oh, my God. Woo. I go for leaderboards? Definitely go for it, man. Here we go. Boom. Oh, there's only one. Thought there was gonna be more. I'm literally single-handedly carrying my team right now. My team's got nothing on me.
Oh my god, this kid destroyed me.
I think you still get kills though. Yeah, you do. This game's feeling nice. We lost? Ah, man, they took our zones. So what did we do? 50 and 13. First game, we did lose. Our teammates literally, he did not do anything. 22 and 22. 22 and 15. 7 and 22. 1 and 19. This guy literally got 1 kill and 19 deaths. Oh my, how do you do that bad? Oh, God.